Andy Emilio for ESU, here with Lou DiBello, one of the best promoters in New York. Just want to know, this fight right here, how important is it moving forward with, like, you know, Long Island boxing? Would this be something that keeps on going?
Look, I think that we're delivering a good show. And for whoever's going to be in Long Island at NYCB Live's Nassau Coliseum Saturday night, they're going to see three great televised fights. They're going to see a whole card of good action and good fights. And I think that when people are entertained and they see the quality of boxing that they get, when we come back the next time, it's going to be bigger. And then we're going to continue to build, you know, boxing on Long Island like we built boxing in Brooklyn. And we're going to do the same thing.
I know, you know, a lot of guys come out along with Chris Algieri. Have anybody inquired about, like, I want next on the next card kind of thing? Has anybody reached out?
You have a lot of fighters from Long Island. You know, Chris is from Long Island. Joe Smith's fighting Sullivan Barrera this weekend. He's from Long Island. There's a 40-pound guy, Cletus Seldon, from Long Island. There are a lot of fighters on Long Island. Patrick Day's on this card fighting Eric Walker. I mean, that's an important fight for Patrick, important fight for Eric, who's undefeated. There's a lot of talent, boxing talent, out, you know, on Long Island, but there's also a lot of boxing talent in the whole, you know, New York area. And it's a matter of really bringing people good fights and entertaining them. And that's what we're going to do on Saturday night. We have a triple header on Fox, a triple header at the Nassau Coliseum. That's going to be really entertaining. And that's our job, entertain people.
There was a little bit of controversy yesterday, Mayweather-McGregor. I want to get your opinion on this and made some headlines. Conor McGregor, when Floyd was at the podium, told him, "Dance for me, boy." People were saying that was, you know, a racist statement. How do you view that?
I don't like that statement. Mm. I mean, it's got like some, like, you know.
You think that maybe
not the most politically correct statement.
Okay.
But Conor's not the most politically correct guy.
Do you think he intended it that way, or does he maybe not have... well-versed in American history.
I think maybe just not so well-versed in history.
Okay.
I don't think he meant like a minstrel show.
Okay.
I also think, like, in Ireland, he's an Irish guy. They call each other boy more often. I don't think he understood it. It didn't sound good.
Yeah.
but look, I mean, look, this is a... They're out there and they're putting on a... Thank you, my friend.
Soup to nuts, sir.
Thank you, my friend. They're out there and they're putting on a show. That's what they're doing. I prefer, though, that personally, like, I didn't, that didn't sound good to me, you know, but I don't think he meant it with that kind of intent. I don't.
What do you think about Paulie Malignaggi being called in to McGregor's camp? Is that a good style, you know, matchup for preparing for Mayweather?
McGregor's not a boxer, man. Paulie does know how to box. So I think that, you know, I got no problem with that. I mean, you help him out a little bit, give him some pointers on boxing.
He said he really wants to be a part of the team, Paulie. Like, he wants to, you know, like, help him out for this because he got called in for the camp.
Well, I mean, you know, look, God bless him. I mean, you know, God bless him. He's helping him out, whatever. I think, personally, in a boxing match, Conor's going to need a lot of help. Mm. He's going to need a lot of help.
The press conference, Mayweather, the trash talk, who do you have winning?
Mayweather or McGregor?
Yeah.
Come on.
Mayweather, right?
Yeah, Mayweather's going to win.
Yeah. Is that going to be something that continues on? Does each show have to be a little bit different because these press conferences are like everybody's showing it, ESPN?
These guys, let me tell you something. They're both big personalities. Mayweather's boxing's biggest star. Conor's got probably the biggest self-promoter, the best mouth, the most promotable guy that MMA's ever had. So, like, these guys know what to do. Like, they're going to go on this whole tour. They're going to go at it. They're going to have some fun. There's probably going to be a little bit of controversy. There's probably going to be some more comments that you're asking about that are politically incorrect, you know, whatever. I mean, they're having some fun. It's the entertainment business. Mm. It's not, you know, it's not like a boxing super fight. It's an event. It's an event. And it may be sort of almost a one-in-a-lifetime kind of event.
I was going to touch on that. Is this really a one-time thing, or will it trailblaze, like, more superstar MMA guys following out superstar boxers?
Have more guys that cross over. It's, you know, a little bit's going to depend on what happens in the ring. I mean, if Mayweather spanks him from pillar to post and Conor never has a moment, it may not be the easiest sell for an MMA guy in a boxing match in the future.
Because I know Adrian Broner kind of called out Nate Diaz.
Well, I mean, look, let's see what happens. Let's worry about this one. This one's going to happen first. Then you'll think about the future. You know what? We still got real boxing to talk about. This Saturday night, there's real boxing. This Saturday night, Nassau Coliseum, a terrific triple header. Figueroa Guerrero, Brown Monahan, Spilka Kanaki. I think there could be action fights. Fox TV. Come out, get tickets. Nassau Coliseum Saturday night. The 29th, Brooklyn, Broner and Mikey Garcia. Terrific, terrific matchup. You know, between two guys at the top of their game. The winner's going to be on pound for pound lists. You know, we still got to, like, you know what? I got no hate at all. I've been out there for a long time. I got no hate at all for Mayweather McGregor. The people wanted it, and the people are getting it. And the people are going to pay for it. And it's their business. If people want to see it, God bless them. You know what I mean? But, like, boxing is boxing, and we still got to pay some attention to our sport.
True. I got one match I want to ask you about. He's calling him out. Errol Spence, Danny Garcia. How possible is that? He said he's willing to skip a hometown fight in Dallas to go straight to a Danny Garcia fight. Is that something we can kind of see, maybe?
I mean, there's a lot. You know, at the moment, there's a tremendous number of matchups you can see in the welterweight division. So we just got to see what materializes. Obviously, that's a really attractive fight. And I'm sure that both guys, like, I've never known. I don't think Garcia's afraid of anybody. Mm. And Spence is a friggin' beast. I mean, there's a lot of potential matchups at welterweight. Let's just see what shakes out.